Kaisar, De Bello Gallico, Book 5, Chapter 30. With this disputation, which is an argument between having been held in either part, so either side were arguing a long time, when it was being opposed sharply by Kada and the rest of the, and the first rank soldiers, Sabinus says, "Oh, screw you guys, I'm going home." Sort of. He says, conquer if you want to, thusly. Win if you will. And he said it, ablative means phrase, with a very clear, quite clear voice, a quite louder voice, so that, purpose clause, that the great part of the soldiers would hear it. Now, this is indirect discourse, but it's actually indirect discourse, orati erector, straight out. I am not that guy, he says, out of you. I'm not that guy who would fear, result clause, relative clause result, who would fear most severely, who would be put to fear by the fear of, by the danger of death. That's not why I'm worried about it. I'm not chicken. These guys, soldier boys, will know. And if quid instead of aliquid, because it's after CNA, and if something more serious would happen, you know, they're going to, they would demand of you, reposco, this is imperfect subjunctive, they would demand of you, so this is a future with a subjunctive, imperfect subjunctive, they would demand of you an account. They would demand from you an account. Who, these guys who, if it's, you know, if it's acceptable through you, this is what you want, have, you know, if you allow it, having been joined with the nearby winter quarters in just the day after tomorrow, in 2 days, these guys would support, you know, complement clause of result, would support a common cause with the rest. They'd be able to have strength, nor not, and not would they be thrown back and banished far from the others, that they would perish with your plan, O Kata, either by by iron or by famine, which is nice. You have an alliteration here, out pharaoh, out fame, so you have a little repetitio, a little also, you have the nice part of metonymy by fire, by iron or the sword. So an interesting story. Basically, Sabinus couldn't make any headway in the council with Kada and the rest of the guys. So he goes on the offensive, says it so that all the soldiers' boy could say and tell Kada and the rest of them they're wussies. Because I'm not the one who's going to be afraid of death. I'm not going to be putting, you know, in danger. These guys, these brave soldier boys, you'll know if something happens to them, they're going to demand an account from you. So he's demagoguing, which is a very anti-Roman thing to do, which is to stir up the crowd. He's not doing it because the soldiers know better because they're Caesar's boys. But what he's doing is he's putting fear into them. Because they can hear this argument going on, and he's saying, hey, we follow Kata, and we're all going to die. We're all going to die. So an interesting close to that argument, and we'll see what happens. Will Kata prevail? Will Titurius prevail? Where's Ambiorix right now? These and all other questions will be answered next time we tune in on The Adventures of Caesar in Gaul. And until that time, true believers, excelsior. Kaisar De Bello Gallico, 531. So after Cotta speaks the sound council and Titurius is saying we need to go, we start with the impersonal in present indicative passive. It is arising, or there is arising out of the council. They, that's Cotta and Titurius, lay hold of each other and they beseech, which would be indirect command. that they not bring the matter, that they not lead the matter down into the greatest danger by ablative means phrased, by their dissension and their obstinacy. Indirect statement that the matter is easy, whether subjunctive, whether they stay or whether they leave, because it's subjunctive, because it's subordinate to an indirect statement clause after orant. If only all would think and approve one thing. So, therefore, why is it subjunctive? Could be potential, also known as deliberative, or it could just straightly be subordinate to an indirect statement. On the other hand, they perceive that no safety is found in dissension. The matter is prodercator, protracted by dispute, argument, to midnight. At length, Cotta, having been moved, gives his hand or yields. The opinion of Sabinus prevails. This is the opinion. It's a subjunctive. It's hortatory. Jussive and hortatory are the same thing. Hortatory when it's first person, jussive when it's third person. That it shall be declared. Let it be declared that they're going to go, indirect statement clause, at first light. So, hey, buddies, it's midnight. We're going to tell you we're leaving in 4 hours. The remaining part of the night is consumed in watches, ablative means phrase, when everyone, every soldier, this would be quisque, wouldn't be a pronoun, it would be an adjective, when everyone was looking around at his stuff, what he is able to carry with him, and what he is forced to relinquish out of the furniture or the stuff of the winter quarters. So it's like, time to backpack, we gotta go. All things are being thought out. Wherefore, or in order that whether or not it could be remained, it's kind of deliberative, not without danger, and that the danger may be increased, and both by the slowness and the watchfulness of the soldiers. So therefore, that there's a danger if they stay, there's a danger if they go. So all the soldiers are worried too. So they set out, deponent, verb form, ablative, place, at first light, out of the camp, so it would be persuaded. Notice this is probably dative. Who was persuaded that the plan? Was not persuaded? This is the indirect statement clause here. Whom it was persuaded that the plan was given, not by an enemy, but by the most friendly man, Ambiorix. So they come out of the camp, just as if they were persuaded by the plan that was given, not by an enemy who just attacked them, but by a very, very friendly man, Ambiorix. So they lead out in a very, very long battle line or troop arrangement, not a battle line, but a marching line. And with the great baggages, they all say, so much to take. I don't want to lose my picture of my girlfriend. And here they are heading out, not as though the council were given by an enemy, not as though they're in hostile territory. But they set out just as if they're on a little afternoon jaunt, supported by their dear, dear friend, Ambiorix. What's going to happen? Are we going to see them get to the next legion? Are we going to see Ambiorix turn traitor? Are we going to see Titurius come to his senses? We'll be taking a cliffhanger for this while we go into the Aeneid, but until that time, we'll find out in the adventures of Caesar and Gaul. Stay tuned, and as all things, Excelsior.